All across Los Angeles, everywhere you turn, you see encampments, you see people living on the streets. On any given night in Los Angeles, we know there are about 4,800 veterans who are experiencing homelessness, according to our last point in time count. Over the past few years, we've seen a lot of improvements in data and how data is collected. And because of that, we're closer to being able to say we have an exact count of who the homeless veterans are and what they like, what they don't like, what motivates them, what doesn't motivate them. So it enhances our skills from a case management perspective to make sure that we're really meeting their specific needs.
Absolutely, at the federal level, we look at data closely with VA, with HUD, make sure we all have the same understanding of each other's data and using that to drive federal policy and programmatic decisions. But I think where the biggest changes have happened in the use of data is at the local level, that we've seen communities move away from just knowing an estimate of how many veterans are experiencing homelessness to having actual by-name lists of veterans in their communities who are experiencing homelessness.
Prior to 2011, we were basically relying in a more paper-based system. And in 2011, we implemented HOMES, which is an online data system that provides real-time data where we're able to clearly identify veterans in the community and what are their individual needs. And based on those, connect them with the right services that they need.
Data is essential in homeless programs because we need to know that what we're doing matters, and it's been a total game changer for us. We track veterans as they're engaged in services, as they enter programs, and as they exit programs. And we look at program outcome information really to help us determine that our programs are providing the most effective services that they can. Looking at things like, did they fully complete their treatment before exiting the program? Did they exit to permanent housing? That sort of thing.
When we first meet with our veterans, we listen to the things that they want to work on. We help them identify some of those goals, but everything is driven by the client. So if the client wants to work on housing, they can work on housing. If they want to work on their mental health issues, they can go ahead and work on that. We have a whole team approach. We have peer supports. We have nurses on our team. We also have housing locators. So each of these specific team players have a role with the veteran. On a weekly basis, we meet to discuss every single veteran on our caseload. Data collection is a great tool for us to communicate better and try to get a holistic picture of what the veteran is going through and identify what resources they may need.
It's amazing that I can send someone to the Welcome Center for evaluation, and I know that they've gotten their screening for housing done that day because I can see it in the notes. The data sharing is there, and it's intrinsic in the care we give. And then I send a veteran to a specialist, and they get seen, and I can see the notes. I can e-consult, and I get follow-up that I would never be able to get in a different setting. To me, that makes the ultimate difference in the care that I'm able to provide as a physician. As a clinic, we can look at our HPAC measures. As a team, we can look at our measures around discharges, frequency of visits, and are we following up in a timely manner to really help engage these veterans?
What I really like about the way that the VA collects data is that it's in a non-judgmental form, but gives me the pertinent information that I need to be of the best assistance to someone.
Hi, I'm George, man.
And see, and that's what I love about this job, is I get to be that person that tries to have you imagine what your fullest life is and help you get there.
Are you service connected yet?
No, I never applied for anything. I never have.
Then you
to.
Have to.
Had
you gotta start, man. You gotta. I spent a little over 12 years homeless on the streets of Skid Row, and I probably would not be alive had it not been for the VA. I can't even put a value on the recovery that I was able to receive by walking through the doors of the VA. And what I really like now is veterans out there now don't even have to walk to the doors, because if they won't come to the VA, we bring the VA to them.
We have outreach teams that all work together within the community. And by identifying veterans on the by-name list, we're able to identify where they last were seen, where they can frequently be visited, and it helps with the engagement. With this population, oftentimes you don't find approaching somebody and then getting them into services immediately. We love it when that happens, but it's often not the case. Repetition is really what brings people in eventually. They see you coming back, you can build rapport, and we wouldn't be able to do that without the use of the data and the information we've got here.
I was literally living homeless under a bridge for 2.5 years, and life was dark until that VA outreach got to me and informed me about the programs. I was hopeless. I was like, there's no way possible for me to get out with my drug problem, with my living conditions, with no support from anybody, with no positive influences. There's no way. You know, they were persistent. They just kept coming back, coming back, coming back. And then eventually I got in the car with them and came over here and enrolled in the Welcome Center.
When a veteran first comes to me, the first thing I do is to do an assessment to find out what he needs to get back on his feet. And my experience is if you let the veteran feel that he's in charge, he's going to work harder. And if you give them the tools they need to be successful, then they do. When I see people like Sterling, it makes me very, very happy. Yeah, because he's going to live. You know, he's gonna thrive.
My homelessness began off and on when I got out of the Coast Guard. And to be where I am in my own place and being a full-time student, I wouldn't be where I am without the VA. I couldn't have done it without the VA. And I'm in a very good place, an emotional, mental, physical support that I'm getting. And my goal is I want to be a VA chaplain and be a certified spiritual counselor that help my veteran brothers and sisters, giving them that support that people have given me.
Data is invaluable. Without that resource, it's difficult to develop a program in terms of the staffing you need, in terms of the content for the program itself, and then really in terms of the outcomes. Are we successful? Without having the access to data and without understanding how to use the data, we really wouldn't be here directly providing services to those veteran populations that need it.
So I think VA is really headed in the right direction with regard to data collection. The home system that they're using is one of the most data-rich troves of information on homeless veterans across the country. They use it for research, they use it for connecting veterans to benefits, and communities are now using it to plan their systems of care to ensure that they've got the right resources at the right time. Because let's face it, you can't solve a problem that you can't see. And having data and being able to use it just in time is the way that you can see the problems to then solve them.
Moving towards the future, I think we can take data and make it even more nimble and make it more accessible. And I think the more interactive we can be with everybody outside of the VA, the better job we're going to do at actually solving veteran homelessness permanently. Once we end homelessness for veterans in Los Angeles, our data systems are going to allow us to maintain that and really move more towards the prevention side to make sure folks aren't falling back into homelessness.
We've been really successful moving a lot of veterans into permanent housing, but we have a lot of veterans who are left to serve. And so looking at the specific demographics of those veterans, learning why we haven't been able to engage them so far and how do we target our interventions there. It's looking at things like the housing market nationally and the changes over time and what pattern that's telling us.
I've been struggling with getting sober and struggling with finding an avenue to do it. And what finally clicked is when actually I got here to the VA and I saw the programs, I saw the area, I saw the living conditions, I saw the people, I saw the energy. Instantly, I was like, yeah, I'm staying there. The VA has given me a lot of hope for the future. And you know, if you want a future and you want to be successful in that, you can achieve it here.
It's really rewarding when you see those veterans who just refuse to come in, they refuse to get services, and then one day, it's that day, is the day that they're ready to get housed, and that's probably the only day they're going to be ready, so we better be there for them, and we better be willing to connect them that day. So those types of moments are really beautiful because we have a lot of folks that just put so much work into developing these relationships with people to finally see them in a home and be successful is what it's all about.